Oh, hey guys. What are you doing here? I mean, I was just about to watch Oversimplified, the Civil War Part 2, but if you guys want to join me, I'd love that. So, yeah, go ahead, subscribe, leave a like, subscribe to Oversimplified. Let's get into full screen mode for y'all here. And, let's do the Civil War Part 2. All right, ominous music. We love it. Yeah, Grant and Sherman. Woo! I like the music playing. It's much more intense. Uh-oh. McClellan, man, what you doing? Yeah, they finally got rid of McClellan. Oh my, finally. Let's skip ahead a bit to get to the. Here, wait. Skip ahead to get to the interesting part here. There we go. Hang on. All right.
Besides had introduced conscription, there was controversy in the North, however, since rich men could simply pay to have someone else fight on their behalf. Riots broke out in New York City.
Oh no.
Enraged mobs, furious at the idea of going to fight for slaves, an idea that many of them simply did not support. However, after so much pressure,
okay, you're in, man. Oh yeah. Jeez. Jeez, that's a lot. Alright. Jeez. Oh my gosh. Oh no. You boys done goofed up. Man, his generals. Yeah.
Switch your browser and block them all. That's right. No YouTube ads.
Yeah, whatever. I don't care. Probably just gonna say buy YouTube Premium. Oh yeah. Yes, ironclads. Alright, let's go! Oh yeah, the seizure of Vicksburg. Heh! Whiskey! You guys gotta go watch part one of this too. Oh. West Virginia. Mount Mama. That's Princess Leia with the mustache. He had the like cinnamon buns or whatever it's called. I forget, I forget. Aw, oh, bread. Bang. Yeah.
already demoralized North would surrender. So in June 1863, with the momentum behind him, General Lee once again entered the North, fighting his way through Maryland and into Pennsylvania.
Oh no.
Set out to meet him for what would be...
Just cut through the gosh dang supply line. Yep, this is the turning point. Gettysburg. I said that a little late, but still.
Units from each army encountered one another and skirmished through the town itself. The townspeople were forced to take refuge, except for one.
Oh yeah, I...
Joseph, what are you doing? I'm not gonna let them... How many times do I have to tell you they're not here for your beans? By the second...
Beans! The soldiers needed food, you know? I don't know. I don't think they actually wanted to do that, but... Maybe they weren't fighting over DC. Maybe they were fighting over beans. Nice, nice. Boom, boom. Yep. Ooh. Yeah, it was. You smell. Snapping Turtle McGee. Yep. Good job, Grant. Oh. Woohoo! Oh, we got Little Rock, now Arkansas Falls. Oh. I've been to Chattanooga. I drove through it, but... Oh no, it's sponsor time.
Me too.
Let's see here. We're gonna go over 100% fee, blah blah blah. And let's just go ahead a bit. Weep.
So thank you. Okay. 4th of July and the siege of Chattanooga.
Woo!
Thank you, General Grant, now in charge of all Western Union armies.
Yeah. Oh, what does he look like?
Grant took on Confederate positions in the mountains around the city.
Oh, nice.
The famous battle above the clouds at Mission Ridge.
Oh.
Grant continued to be Lincoln's number one guy. With these victories, Lincoln hoped the war was finally turning. Back in Gettysburg, the entire town had been turned into a hospital to care for the scores of wounded men. Throughout the war, on both sides, women such as Clara Barton rose to the occasion, doing crucial work on the home front and volunteering as nurses. Those who had given their lives, a new national cemetery was to be established.
I want to visit that so bad.
Lincoln traveled out to attend the opening ceremony. At the event, the main speaker spoke for 2 hours. Then, Abraham Lincoln was called forward to give some brief, appropriate remarks. In just 2 minutes, he masterfully and poignantly iterated America's national purpose and the need to continue the fight. The Gettysburg Address would become one of the most famous speeches in American history. While they were now making progress, still couldn't find a decisive victory in the east. That was bad news for Lincoln because his presidency was now in its fourth year. In 1864, there was an election.
Oh no.
This too, and with little hope left of being able to threaten the North militarily.
But they have a BTS calendar? Is that what that is?
Since Lincoln, emancipation and the war itself
people
in the North were sick of war and wanted to put it behind
them. Pardon me. Oh yeah, wait who's to see who's running against him.
If Lincoln loves General Grant so much, then why doesn't he put him in charge of the campaign in the east? Well, guess what, loyal subscriber? You've hit the nail. You're bold, Grant. I'll grant.
Oh.
Promoting you to general, and I ain't taking you for granted. Now, I want
stop, man. Stop bullying Grant. Nice, nice. Oh my! What? Is that real? Ooh. But. Oh, well. Alright. Come on, man! That cost a lot of money! Oh no. To demoralize the North as much as he could. But here's what set Grant apart from others. He knew Lee was running out of men, and that the North by comparison had planned Grant would throw his forces at Lee. And guys, they're just spawning in too fast. Would give the order to keep moving forward and flank Lee again and again. Oh. 6 weeks, 80,000 men would be killed. Yeah. Yeah. Uh-oh, stinky! Yeah. Nope, that's not very good. Tricksy Trickster! But! Mm-mm. There goes your hat. Oh no. Yeah, here we go.
Guess what, baby? I'm back. That's right. General George B. McClellan.
Oh wow.
Against Abraham Lincoln, my fellow countrymen. If you elect me, I, the great General George McClellan,
the great.
And valiantly win the war.
Unlike this douchebag. Oh yeah, General Sherman. He just came in clutch and saved everybody. A fun warship game here. Alright, nice, nice.
Atlanta had been under siege by General Sherman for just over a month.
Just over. Oh yes, yes. Bye bye. One of the Confederacy's most important cities had fallen. Woohoo! Bum 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 bum. Woohoo!
The troops in particular voting overwhelmingly.
Yeah.
Hey man, looks like you lost. No hard feelings? I didn't lose.
We failed to win. Nice. Why is Frederick Douglass, or I'm assuming that's who it is, supposed to be not cheering? North or South? Comrade! Oh no! Here, let me. There we go, that's better. That's better. Oh no.
With further
yeah. It ain't over yet, baby. Noise. Do something unprecedented. Remove his 62,000 men from their supply line and march through the heartland of the Confederacy where they would live off the land. Like Napoleon. They live off the land. They tore up railroads, burned farms, and nice. Communication lines. They also liberated thousands of slaves. Oh, yeah. Was estimated at 1.4. Woohoo! That's in modern money, but still. Sherman, it was better than losing yet more men in battle. In December, yep. I'd say. Jeez. 60,000 of Lee's men had deserted. Numerous Union attempts to break through had failed, but when the breakthrough finally came, it came quick. On April 2nd, a Union assault finally pushed the Confederates from their defenses. Hey man, there's no need to evacuate, right? You'll rescue us like last time, right? Sorry, can't hear you. Lee narrowly escaped the city, hoping he'd be able to meet up with General Johnson and continue the fight. Grant chased him down. Richmond was evacuated, and Jefferson Davis went on the run. As they left, the Confederates set fire to military buildings, but the flames burned out of control, and as the Union troops arrived, they became firefighters. A couple of days later, Abraham Lincoln
was
in a war-torn city.
Grant caught up to Lee at Appomattox Courthouse,
here we go.
On April 9th, 1865, that Lee saw no point in continuing. Sir, listen, bub, I drank a bit too much last night.
Oh, here we go.
Wilmer, all right, can we all just hurry up and get this over with?
Martha, not
I'm cleaning.
Yes.
Want us to get rats?
Let the woman clean.
Now spoke respectfully to one another. When Lee left, his face filled with emotion. Grant's men began to cheer, but Grant ordered them to stop. He knew that now was the time for reconciliation. Just over 2 weeks later, General Johnson would surrender to Sherman, ending the war for 89,000 Confederate soldiers in the largest surrender of the war. Not every Confederate state had surrendered, but the war was as good as over. Across the North, church bells rang out and celebrations erupted. In Washington, Lincoln gave a speech from the White House to a jubilant crowd, in which, among various things, he expressed his support for voting rights. Lincoln had seen the nation through its deepest crisis. The presidency had visibly
It did something to him, you could see. Nice!
I think I'm the tiredest man on Earth. I'm not sure tiredest is a word, but geez, the man's exhausted.
Yeah. Give him a break, man.
Lincoln clearly was looking forward to being a president in a time of peace. He was apparently very cheerful, surprising his wife, and he told her that between the war and the loss of their son, they'd both been very miserable. Now, it was time to be happy.
You see his wife with a little smile on his face?
Lincoln attended a play with his wife and some friends at Ford's Theater.
Oh.
Oh. Booth swallowed two glasses of brandy. He slipped quietly into the president's booth and awaited for the audience's laughter to rise. The president was shot in the back of the head. Booth fled the city. Soldiers carried Lincoln to a boarding house across the street. There, doctors declared there was nothing they could do. Surrounded by his heartbroken wife, son, and members of cabinet, at 7:20. Scattered fighting continued until May, when when the last Confederate forces in Texas disintegrated. The southern states came under northern military occupation to prevent any further rebellion, and a very difficult era of Reconstruction began. Over 3 million Americans had fought brother against brother.
Two-thirds from disease.
The bloodiest conflict in U.S. history.
But still.
But the Union had been preserved. I could say the real winners were those who were to never again be slaves. Further amendments passed by Congress gave black individuals the right to citizenship and to vote. Significant progress had been made. However, entering into the 20th century, it was clear the fight for equality would continue.
Yeah.
In modern America, the man who fought to preserve the nation and never...
Oh, I want to see that, and you see.
...stands as a symbol of honesty, empathy, humility, perseverance, and courage. A continuous reminder of what has forged America and what it should ever strive to be.
It looks like we're done. So I've actually been to the Lincoln Museum and his house in Springfield, which is neat. And you guys also know that Ulysses S. Grant had actually became president afterwards. And I thought that was pretty cool, you know? So, anyway, thanks for watching. I gotta get these videos posted. Then I'm just gonna relax tonight. But, yeah, thanks for watching. See you guys on the next one.